on court, Stefano Galifi, the charismatic, flamboyant, and often controversial Italian number one. He's actually represented France and Italy in international competition. His opponent in the red, it's showing up very bright on more orange, I guess I should say, the young Egyptian Mohamed Arafa, making his second Pro Squash Tour tournament appearance. He reached in January the finals of the Philadelphia Open. Lost in a tough match to Adrian Lianza of the United States. This is the first time Galifi and Arafa have faced off in a professional match. And the opening point of the opening game goes to Arafa. The voice you'll hear in the background is Allentown, Pennsylvania's Nathan Tico calling the decisions for this match. And an error from Galifi gives a 2-point advantage to Mohamed. And there's a point for Stefano. That ball sails out of court. 2-2 now. Going cross court, that ball appeared to clip the tin. Point to Arafa. There's a 4-2 lead after the first extended rally of the match. Galifi takes that ball early, puts it short, wins the point 3-4. This is the fourth quarterfinal match of the afternoon as that ball bounces off of Stefano's racket. In the first match, Wade Johnson of Australia beat Ricky Weisskopf of El Salvador. Won that match in 3 games. Stefano goes deep to pick up that ball. Mohamed putting him under some pressure. Galifi recovers. And point to Galifi. Forgive me. Yeah, point to Galifi. In the second quarterfinal of the match of the day, Fabian Kalaitis just edged Michelangelo Bertocchi. That went the full 5 games, and Fabian just edged him 11-9 in game 5. In the third game, the young Egyptian Mohamed El Shabini got by Shahid Khan of England in 3 games. And now we are in our fourth quarterfinal match of the day, featuring the veteran Stefano Galifi from Italy versus the young rising Egyptian Mohamed Arafa. We're broadcasting to you live on ProSquashTV.com from the headquarters of Live Technology, high-tech company based in the Hudson Valley in Tuxedo Park, New York, maybe 40 minutes northwest of New York City. The president of the company, originally from South Africa, as Mohamed appeals to the point, gets it. Galifi looks at the referee, but knows he hit a loose shot. Stefano says a word to the referee, but he should know that shot was fairly loose. As I was saying, the president of the company, Wayne Rivers, originally from South Africa, loves the game of squash, so much so that he built a squash court in his company here. Actually, as I see sitting in the stands, is the head pro of the Live Technology program here, Phil Wilkins, originally from Wales. Phil is actually one of only a dozen U.S. squash level 3 certified coaches in the United States. And he's built up a nice program here in the Hudson Valley, working with Friends of the Barn. He actually gets down to YMCA in northern New Jersey. So he's a busy man, former college coach. Building up quite a solid reputation as one of the better pros, best teaching pros in the United States. He's got a nice facility here as well. 9-6. Mohamed and Stefano are bumping a little bit, both basically moving around each other pretty well, but there's a little bit of contact here for sure. 7-9. Stefano is definitely one of the most emotional players in the world circuit. And his unique flair and style bring a very unique entertainment experience for fans watching. But he is also, without doubt, one of the most talented and gifted players. Great hands, but he is facing game ball here against the talented young Egyptian. Who took that early? 11-7, Mohamed Arafa surprises the Italian number one. We'll be back in just a moment after a word from the Downtown Cleveland Association and the law offices of Joe Rosen.
So we definitely made a commitment to the city and to ourselves for at least 10, 15 years.
We have views all the way from downtown out to Lake Erie.
Being a young professional downtown, this is like the place to be. The energy downtown is amazing.
Playhouse Square, the restaurants are our favorite part.
It's a city that's really coming back and becoming the city to be in.
Obtaining citizenship should be easy, but it's not. Issues such as time out of the country, past DUI convictions, and other minor criminal convictions can cause serious problems. These problems lengthen the process and can increase the complexity. On the other hand, I have had clients who have obtained citizenship through a parent and didn't know it. My name is Joe Rosen. My immigration law offices have helped many people like you successfully get through the citizenship application process. Our focus is immigration, and as a former FBI agent and a lawyer, I know how government agencies operate. My knowledge and experience will make dealing with the Department of Homeland Security easier for you and could be the difference between getting citizenship or not. Call me at 678-461-6046 to make an appointment for a consultation.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are courtside in the quarterfinal match of the 2013 Bottini Fuel PST World Open. On court right now, the young Egyptian Mohamed Arafa, who just appealed for that point, but the referee ruling that Galifi had cleared the ball in advance, denying the appeal. Mohamed doesn't like the call, but he doesn't challenge it either. Often the case where players will test the referee early in the match to see how the referee is making decisions. Stefano gets the first 2 points of this game. Stefano is the number one seed in this tournament, but Mohamed is not backing down at all, working hard, playing like he expects to win, and so far, having won game one of the match, 11-7, he's given Stefano all he can handle. Stefano takes that ball early, puts it away. Four serving, one now. 4-1. Stefano on that ball early. After defensive boast, keeps it short, drops it. Mohamed can't pick it up. 5-1. Mohamed has a little trickle boast up at the front. Doesn't fool Galifi, who puts it deep in the corner. Now has a 6-1 lead. these guys are moving very well around each other, covering all corners of the court. Mohamed takes that 0.26. Squash was voted by Forbes magazine just a few short years ago as the best sport on the planet for getting in shape and staying fit. And as these guys are moving around, you can see why. The constant motion, the lunging, the twisting, the turning as they collide in the center. Referee awards that point to Mr. Galifi. An amateur player in an hour-long match will burn about 1,000 calories. At the professional level, these guys' heart rates will be up in excess of 180 beats a minute for a lot of the match, and they'll burn nearly 1,500 calories. Both players work in the front of the court very well there. Stefano getting the better of it, though, takes an 8-2 lead here in game number two. Stefano is down one game, though, in the match, as the young Egyptian took the first game 11-7. Stefano extending to several balls up there in the front and finally puts one deep just out of the reach of Mohamed. Stefano is talking about the referee's call at the front that the ball was down. Mohamed clearly believes the ball was down. The referee called it down. Stefano doing what he does. Asking questions. 3 serving 9. Mohamed giving up that point as he was in the path. And now Stefano takes commanding lead 11-3, 10-3, and now 11-3 to close out the game. And now we're knotted at one game apiece. We'll be back in just a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back live courtside. Players are back on court and have just begun game three. Stefano Galifi in the white facing off against... Well, there's a tough call. Mohamed Arafa running across court to go get the ball. Appealed for the point, didn't get it. Objecting to the referee, but the referee gives the point to Mr. Galifi. He seemed frustrated, but did not choose to challenge the call, which is his right. Point to Arafa. Yeah, a loose ball from Galifi. Arafa appeals for it and gets the point in this case. 1-1. Mohamed won the first game 11-7 over Stefano. Stefano came back with a little bit more, a little increased sense of urgency in game two and won at 11-3. Mohamed was getting some coaching between games from his friend Mohamed El Shabini, who just prevailed in the earlier quarterfinal match. Mohamed doing a good job of controlling this point, moving Stefano around the court. A little bit of contact here on court. Stefano looking to get every ball. Mohamed questioning whether or not there was a double bounce. I didn't see one on court. Referee saying the balls were good until the final one. Galifi has a 2-1 lead. Squash is played by an estimated 20 million people across the globe, as you saw in that commercial. The entire squash community globally is supporting the Squash 2020 Back the Bid campaign to get squash into the Olympics. If you use Twitter, we'd encourage you to go send your notes, hashtag VoteForSquash, as Mohamed ties the game up. For more information, you can go to the World Squash Federation's website, worldsquash.org, or squash2020.com. Contact here. Both players frustrated by each other on that point. Monsieur Galifi appeals for the point and gets it from the referee. Mohamed saying that there's a little bit of pushing and contact on court. Stefano, as always, doing a little chatter here. Ironically, he got the point. Not sure what he's arguing about, but he does nonetheless. That one a little bit too tough for Mohamed. Point to Galifi, 4-2. Well, that one's a tough call, actually. You could see that Galifi kept stepping back into him. I don't blame him for challenging that call at all. Well, in a split decision from the officials, the call stands. As we saw in our camera angle from the left side of the court, Stefano did keep stepping back. I'm not sure that was the way I would have ruled had it gone to me. Stefano calling his ball down there. And actually, there was some disagreement among the officials on that call. Nice finish from Stefano, 6-3. We're broadcasting to you live from the corporate headquarters of Live Technology in Tuxedo Park, New York, or on the banks of Sterling Lake in the Hudson Valley. The squash court is tight, and in a competitive match, it's often the case that the boys are going to find each other's bodies with a little bit of bumping. The court is 32 feet front to back, 21 feet left to right. It's a little bit of a bump there as he tripped over his foot. Yeah, I think that's the right decision, actually. Galifi clearly was not blocking. Mohamed wanted to go play the ball, and you could see on the camera angle that he just tripped over his foot. Replaying that rally there is a fair outcome. You don't want anybody extending themselves too far where they could put themselves in an unsafe position. Galifi is chatting a lot with the referee right now, but unnecessarily. That ball looked good to me. Well, after challenging the call, both challenge officials disagreed with me and saw that the ball bounced twice on his racket. In that case, I'm sure I got it wrong. And once again, Stefano, who gets the call, for some reason keeps talking to the referee. He's such a unique character. Even when he's getting the decisions, he still wants to debate them. I'm not quite sure why he does that. In this case, Stefano's ball comes out a little bit. Arafa appeals for the point and gets it. Four, seven. think I had that. If it was 4-6.
8-4.
I'm not sure I had that score right, but referee's calling it 8-4. Double bounce right there.
Nine,
Stefano
four.
Gets the point. 9-4. 10.
Five, nine.
Arafa gets the point. 5-9. Another 10 from Stefano. 6-9. Stefano puts that ball deep in the back of left court, just beyond the reach of Mohamed. And with it earns game ball here in game three. Mohamed Arafa won game one, 11-7. Galifi came back and took game two, 11-3. And now he has game ball in his racket in game three. And there it is, game to Stefano Galifi, 11-6. He now has a 2-1 advantage in this quarterfinal match, 2013 Bottini Fuel PST World Open. We'll be back in just a moment.
So we definitely made a commitment to the city and to ourselves for at least 10, 15 years.
We have views all the way from downtown out to Lake Erie.
Being a young professional downtown, this is like the place to be. The energy downtown is amazing.
Playhouse Square, the restaurants are our favorite part.
It's a city that's really coming back and becoming the city to be in.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back courtside. This is Joe McManus talking to you from the Pro Squash Tour's Bottini Fuel World Open, being broadcast to you live on Pro Squash TV from the headquarters of Live Technology in Tuxedo Park, New York. Stefano Galifi on court right now has a 2-1 advantage over the young Egyptian Mohamed Arafa. I do want to say a thank you to the Downtown Cleveland Alliance for their support of Pro Squash Tour. We actually have a great event each year in the fall at the Cleveland Skating Club. Head pro out there, Ray Lindsay, doing a nice job setting up the event, and it's become one of the favorite stops of the players on the tour. Several of them have enjoyed seeing the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame out there in Cleveland. Really a great city. Galifi has been on the court early in each of these games. Mohamed taking a little bit of extra time coming on court. The referee has just asked him to come back. The players are only given 2 minutes between games, so I'm wondering if Mohamed needed an extra second. Sometimes a quick restroom break, or in this case, it looks like he was working on his goggles. Pro Squash Tour requires protective eyewear for all of our players. As Mohamed in the orange shirt gets on court, he won the opening game 11-7. Stefano Galifi came back and won games 2 and 3, 11-3, 11-6. The voice you hear in the background is the voice of Pro Squash Tour referee and Allentown, Pennsylvania native Nathan Tico, who will be officiating the later rounds of this tournament. I do want to say a thank you to our local sponsors who have brought Pro Squash Tour back to the Tuxedo Park area. United Check Cashing, Drug Check Consulting, Cool Cap, Bottini Fuel, Kiel Heating and Air Conditioning, Laxton Money Making Machines, as well as Halstamat, and of course our host for this weekend's tournament, Live Technology. Players turning to the referee for guidance on whether or not the ball was good. So the referees, the challenge officials, not able to agree and overrule the referee's decision. The range, the officials' call stands. Stefano, as you might imagine, is questioning the call. Stefano saying he thought the ball was down, but the referee seeing it differently. Now we're tied at one apiece in game three. Two all. While I was talking, I think I lost a point along the way. I didn't keep up the score. Both players covering all corners of court in this extended rally. Ends with an unforced error of a 10 by Mohamed. Stefano, though, he's the Italian number one, bases himself right now in Odessa in the Ukraine, where he has a teaching job at a club there called Four Muller. He's certainly a global citizen, as he has played in international competition representing France and Italy. Born in one country, but parents from another. He has dual citizenship. Right there with an unforced error, giving the point to Mohamed, who now leads game four, 4-3. That's served just in. Galifi is in sprawling, but gets the point to a neutral spot. Takes control. Now has the Egyptian on the move. And eventually closes out the point. You notice both players sitting at the center court area. We call it the T region. And if you're new to squash, the simplest strategy is to put your opponent in the corner and keep yourself in the center. That way you're just a couple steps from any ball on the court. Galifi, with his racket raised to the center of the court, appeals to the referee for the point. The referee gives it to him. And as again, as Stefano does, even though he gets the decision, still has a few extra questions. That ball sails out of court. A little bit too strong. 6-4 to Stefano. Forgive me. That's twice. There we are. Thought I got it wrong again. 6-4, Stefano. Mohamed raising his racket at the back, wants the point. Referee taking a moment to make his decision. A little bit of chatter from both players. The referee awards the point to Mohamed Arafa. As you can imagine, Stefano is not going to like that at all. Stefano challenges the call. First official said the point should have gone to Galifi. Second challenge officials, both challenge officials. The The challenge officials have a split decision, so the original call will stand. Players have the right to challenge the official's call in pro squash to a tournament action. There are some challenge officials seated in the front row on the left and right wall. If the players don't agree with the referee's call, they can challenge it, as he did in this case. And when there was a split decision, the referee's call stands. Galifi wins that rally, 7-5. If he wins this game, he'll close out the match. Mohamed, looking for that ball early, takes it early, but clips the tin, giving Stefano an 8-5 lead here in game four. Stefano has a 2-1 advantage. Mohamed conceding the point there on a loose ball. 9-5. Referee calling out the score. 9-5 to Stefano Galifi. Right side. Stefano serving from the right side. It's 2 points away from taking game four and winning the match 3-1. And there is a tin from Mohamed. 10-5 match ball to Galifi. That ball just beyond the reach of Mohamed. We'll go on court for a quick player interview. Mohamed, come on over. Well played. You took game one. You came out very strong. Stefano came back and won the next three. What was it like on court for you?
In the first game, I was pretty focused. And the second game, he controlled. I played a lot of cross. So he controlled the tee very well. That's why I was keep running. That's good.
Yeah, a little bit of bumping. Both of you were talking to the referee a little bit. How was it, how did it feel on court?
I don't know about the calls, if it was right or wrong, but I was the second, third game focused with the ref. Then I started to play late, so that was good.
Well, we're thrilled to have you here in Tuxedo Park.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the young Egyptian, Mohamed Arafa. Stefano, congratulations. Mohamed came out very strong, took game one. You had to fight back in the later games here.
Yeah, I know. I woke up this morning and I knew what was expecting me. So I'm not surprised in a way. The first game, maybe I make a little bit too fast, too easy to him, to the front. And he's too good at it. So I changed a little bit in the end and tried to get him on the tight ball. And he works out. I'm very happy.
Well, you've got your work cut out for you because tonight you're going to have another young Egyptian, Mohamed El Shabini, who moves just as well. What can fans expect tonight?
Wow. I think there's going to be good squash. Yeah. Hi, hi, hi. This, I see the kid there is looking at me like appetizer. Well, I'm going to get a cup of coffee now and get ready.
Well, congratulations, a good quarterfinal. Ladies and gentlemen, Italian number one, Stefano Galifi. For folks watching at home, we've finished our four quarterfinal matches of the night. We'll be broadcasting live again at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and you can watch the matches live from Live Technology Headquarters on ProSquashTV.com. My name is Joe McManus, and thank you for watching Pro Squash Tour Action today. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, watching at home, Thank you for tuning in to this afternoon's Professional Squash Tour action at the quarterfinal matches. We'll be back tonight at 6:30 p.m. You can watch us live on prosquashtv.com. For now, this is Joe McManus signing off. Have a good day.